For a minute there, I thought you might be in love with me or something.
Alex, you will forever be the boy who wiped bogeys on my favourite party dress, okay?
I think not telling you was a way to keep the dream alive, you know?
It's been 2 weeks.
You still saw me as Rosie.
I walked through the door with you.
Alex!
The air was cold, but something about it felt like home somehow. And I left my scarf there at your sister's house, and you still got it.
You'd be happier.
In your drawer.
Run away, you bastard!
Wait, come on, you're coming too.
Down like
pieces into place, and I can picture we're getting married after all
these days. And we just keep missing each other.
That magic's not I'm Rosie, no more.
And this has got to be okay, but one of the happiest days of my life. Choosing the person that you want to share your life with is one of the most important decisions any of us makes. Because when it's wrong, it turns your life to grey.
I pity you, Alex!
Your friendship has brought glorious technicolor to my life. It's been there even in the darkest of times. I am the luckiest person alive, that gift.
I wanted to see you, for Christ's sake, you're my best friend!
I hope I didn't take it for granted. Think maybe I did. Because sometimes you don't see that the best thing that's ever happened to you is sitting there, right on your nose.
The best. I realized, tonight.
It never happened.
You forgot.
I've realized that no matter where you are, or what you're doing, or who you're with, I will always, honestly, truly, completely, love you.
If you reject him now, he's gonna make it his life's mission to go out there and meet the most perfect, beautiful girl in the world just to try and get over you. A kid's on the way, who's gonna have two parents, by the way, not one. She won't be you. She won't be you. I need to cure my arms. Rosie, can I take you to dance?
I'm going with you. Better late than ever.